Ladies and gentlemen, I'm back with another video, and today we have market strategy for June 2021, and we have resilient markets, inflation concern in US, monsoon sector updates, and also investment ideas. And I will calculate and show you how to reduce risk in the given stocks. Let's go ahead. Not wasting much more time in the market outlook for June 21. Despite losses from second COVID wave curtailing economic activities, equity markets in India remain broadly resilient. Indian markets performed strongly in May 2021 with Nifty 50 making a new high and BSE Sensex gaining 6.5%. In US, the CPI rose to 4% from earlier spike, and the US president unveiled 6 lakh crore budget proposal to restore the nation's infrastructure, expanding the social safety net, combat income inequality. Indian GDP grew 1.6% in quarter 4 FY 2021. In FY 2021, the Indian economy contracted by 7%. CPI inflation moderated to 4.29% against 5.52% in March. RBI Central Board approves 99,122 crore surplus, and this surplus will be transferred to contingency fund. The contingency risk buffer at 5.50%. The transfer would be helpful in partly absorbing the impact of second wave of COVID on government finances. Now, as per the monsoon seasonal rainfall is likely to be 98% of the long period average with a moderate error of -5% to -5%. Expectation of the third consecutive year of good monsoon, stable crop prices and higher rabi crop output. The previous year gives well for demand in sector like agrochemicals, tractor, FMCG. Now, as per the sector updates, Union Cabinet approves 18 crore production linked to PLI scheme for building gigafactories to manufacture batteries to boost towards local manufacturing along with scale benefits over time, bringing down the cost of ownership for electric vehicles and increase their penetration in India. Steel industry expects that the structural policy changes in China towards reducing steel exports, initiatives towards reducing carbon emissions shall help keeping regional prices elevated. We believe that domestic demand is witnessing headwinds due to second wave of COVID and sharply increasing in steel prices. Indian pharmaceutical companies are better placed to harness opportunities and report healthy growing going ahead. Pharma sector remains amongst a few sectors that will continue its upward march. We feel that the sector is well poised to continue the current outperformance against broad index on account of structural changes. Now, towards the outlook, the market has largely looked through the second wave given concise view of limited economic earning impacts of the second wave. Similarly to the last fiscal year, the half of FY 2022 is going to be a challenge for corporate India. There is a hope of recovery coming back in second half year quarter of 2022, provided we don't have a third wave. One can look to invest in selectively in banks, IT sector, housing finance, construction, insurance, oil and gas, metal, retailing and telecom sector. While the markets are strong, investors will continue to focus on daily caseload trajectory phase of lifting the lockdown restriction and vaccination ramp up over the next few months. Potential risk of third wave of COVID pandemic, which can impact economy and earning growth projections. Rising inflation could lead to central bank rethinking its easy monetary policy. Elevated commodity prices continue to put cost pressure and risk to earning largely in manufacturing sectors. Increase in crude oil prices could impact the economy and corporate earnings. Now, these are the top investment ideas we have BPCL, HDFC, Hindalco Industries, L&T, LG, Integlobe Aviation, Mahindra and Mahindra, all the ratings that are given are buy. Now I will check, I will show you how to reduce the risk. Okay, so let's begin. I'll show you again. I calculated previously. Okay, so we have the upside and here we have the asset allocation. Now to do the asset allocation is equal to 1 divided by 6. Enter. It's 1 divided by 6 because there are 6 stocks that have been recommended and we have to allocate 0.16% to each stock. Now if we buy all stocks, let's check the risk. The risk is given by standard deviation. Is equal to, double click, okay, standard deviation, click and drag, close the bracket, enter. Then we have average. To get average is equal to, double click, and then click and drag, close the bracket, press enter, average. And here we will check the future return. To check the future return, we will start the formula is equal to asset allocation multiply by upside plus, let's go to the next one, upside multiply by asset multiplied by upside. Let's check again. No, it's correct. Let's go to the next one. Upside multiplied by asset allocation plus, let's go to the next one. Upside multiplied by asset allocation plus, upside multiplied by asset allocation plus upside multiply by asset allocation, press enter. Before pressing enter we will recheck. Okay, it's correct. Enter is, we are getting 21. Now let us check for top 3 stocks. For these top 3 stocks, first let's check the risk. Risk is given by standard deviation. Double click, click and drag, close the bracket, enter. 5% risk. And here we'll check the average. Close the bracket. ट्वेंटी is the average and we'll check for the future risk. Okay, future return, so is equal to upside multiply by asset allocation plus, let's go to the next one, upside multiply by asset allocation plus, upside multiply by asset allocation, enter. So we are getting 10%. See, in this case it is more advisable to buy all the stocks because here the risk that we are getting is 3.9% and future returns is 21% in Czech here. Here the risk is 5% and future return is 10%. So in this case, it is more advisable to buy all the stocks. And as for Kotak Securities, you have to sell the, you have to book profits, or you can sell it at the fair value. So thank you. You can take a screenshot of this. Okay, friends. So please follow all the guidelines, follow the SOPs, stay safe and subscribe to my channel. Share this to all the investor friends. Thank you very much.